And of course, I got compensated. Luckily, I was smart enough to buy that into a piece of land, very piece of land in Kuantan, which is now I can retire on that. So that's something, in a way.
How do you market yourself during that time?
Very difficult, because part of the people knows about me, and part of it I got to go to lectures, seminars and so on. That's how sometimes you get job, because I have no connection at all. You know, I don't belong to any political parties. I could, if I want to, and I could get a lot of job, but I didn't. And I want to maintain my independence. This is how it was. But as luck has it, I think it's lucky in some way, because there are not many Bumiputra architects at the time. And I was driving in France, and I was helping Mara at the time. They know my jasara. And also maybe University Kebangsaan, maybe somebody else and so on that knows me and said, there you are, that's what I got, university job. In the beginning, many of the universities have a job from the universities, University Kebangsaan, for their first administrative building and the beginning of the building of University Kebangsaan and the library as well.
Just before that, Dato, I'm just trying to be clear on what is the practice right now. That you have to have some sort of practice license.
Oh yes, you get to have
one. When was it?
Well, you have to have practice license at that time too.
So
but I already got one in Australia.
So
it's a matter of conversion, because Australian Institute of Architects is the same thing as the RIBA. And at that time, anybody has RIBA memberships, corporate membership, is automatically they could become.
How long did you practice in Australia?
Quite a long time, as I said, I not practice, I got training by that. But as soon as finished, I will practice already. So I got already the practice.
So that's like what is some practical, what do you call practical?
My practical training, as I told you, I've done it before university, and towards the 5 years during university vacation. So I filled up all the time. So that was easier than.
You mentioned that you built the church
at the time. Yeah, this is during the time, because my mentor who thought very highly of me, and during that time it was easy and yet not easy to get a job. Luckily I have, as I said, I worked as before with Singapore Improvement Trust as a trustman, and I have done some work already. So with that I have what we call a sample of work. So when I try to get a job, they always have to look at your what your trustman's scheme. And I showed to them and immediately say, when can you start? And I got a very good salary too, because of that time, you know, this is how it was before. You know?
So continuing
with that, the practice was a very hard beginning, as I said. You know, economically everything has been doomed at that time. But the products has opened up the doors, you know, and seeing that the sky is the limit at that time, if you have money, you can build any amount of building. There's no restriction on the appropriation.
All right, and you said you broke off from the AB.
Architect Bristol to Malaysia.
Yes. What did you set up? What was the name?
Then after that, on my old man, he just
Kasturi. Just
Kasturi,
that's the first.
1977. Yes.
So formally, the UCAM is your first job for the.
Yes. After that, when I started, no, the UCAM was part of that before, but I completed that.
Okay.
Part of that was completed.
Bangsar.
In Bangsar, yes. That's back in 1977, and at that time my office was in Bangsar, Dato' Zanam, and part of the struggle of that. That was a real struggle. As I said, the scenario was different during that time. Architect is also entrepreneur. And I got these chaps and saying that I got this site, but I have no money. Can we do something about it? I said, try, I said. And true enough, I went to place to place, and at that time, UDA, that is Urban Development Authority, was just started, and they are looking for jobs as well. And I went there several times to have a joint venture for my clients. Before that, I went to every bank. Of course, no bank would give money at that time, especially if it's not viable. I still believe, I know, I would not mention the name. I was so disappointed. After here is keen person has a potential, and it is after just during that time, which is hard time, somebody encouraged them. Went to Bank Bumiputera Putra to get some loans for my clients. No, they said the project not viable. Go to another, you know, it's not viable. See the minister at that time of finance or so. No, they cannot help it. So luckily, as luck turns out, UDA just starting. And they also try to get jobs, you know, in a way to start. So how, somehow or other, we marry them together. So they started it, and more recently joint venture with my client. And his name is Dato Zainab at that time. And this is the famous Azrai family. Anyway, since then, we started that. And then the first, probably the first Bumiputera Multi-Story building ever been done. And because of that, she got his tax refunds. So that was how it was done, it's hard beginning. Every job has its own story, an interesting story. But I won't bore you into that. But it is an interesting story. But a job like that, not only I practice, but I bring in new concept. Not only concept of design, but concept of construction. And during that time, two things I brought that. There is the waffle step construction. Waffle step has been done everywhere, but in Malaysia it has not been done. And that is the first waffle step construction I used there.
Which building?
That is Bangunan Dato' Zainab, okay. Which is now called Etika.
All floors you use waffle step?
No, only the first floor where what you call transfer floor. And the technique of construction also, it is innovative. To such an extent that whether I should be proud, some people say somebody immediately your building is to be proud. Whether the other architect has no imagination, I don't know. And this is quite big architect. He copied literally everything in it, the same module, the same technique, and so on. And that is Bangunan Getah, if you go there. It's exactly the same. Anyway, let me start the point. So when I do something, it's always must have some innovation in terms of construction, technique, and so on. And as I said, every building has its own story. There's another book, you know, you can write a lot of it. And during that time, construction is not easy, especially multi-story building. Probably that's the first one, the biggest one, because it's higher than the next door at that time. Also, the Bank Bumiputera opposite it was completed. Anyway, that's how the practice. And because the competition is coming in, the international competition for the land banking, and that's where I spend my time day and night. Again, this is it's a story. That you have to do something about this, and you know, you do research, you do all kind of things around the world to come out. And I know that 1 week or 2 weeks before the final date for submission, a friend of mine who's now just passed away 2 months ago is an accountant, always visiting me at home. And when I was not at home, my wife said he's still in the office, so he went to see me in the office. And he just, what are you doing so late? Look at it, I said, don't you see in front of me here? Oh, what is that? Oh, this is supposed to be competition for the bank. I see, he said. If it is a bank, where is the banking hall? So when he remarks that, I said, my God, he's right. Where is the banking hall? During that time, when you go to the bank, the banking hall must look, the roof must be very easily recognizable. And I haven't got that.
for me.
So when he left, I restarted the whole thing again. My God, it's day and night working on it. To emphasize the bank call, the first thing you've got to reach is to see, identify the bank. And you've got to give the sense of aloofness for your customers, because he's important. So you must go there, you've got this grand scheme of a hall. Today it's not like that. You know?
Or inspiring.
Or inspiring. And then you've got to, you know, then you've got to bring them into a hill. And how do you bring people to the hill? You know, so you've got to use escalators. So we are the first one in the world to use escalators outside. But of course I covered it. And to go through and then into a big hall again. And then to give something special in that, and then you have gallery by the side and cafe for people to, you know, sit down and wait for somebody. And you've got to work out the multiple of lift during that time. Can you imagine that you are the first time to do that kind of building? Complicated building in many ways. And you want to preserve the hill as well. And at that time when I did that, of course the famous what's Singh is that he was very environmentalist. He was trying to boycott it and bringing, you know, people to stop it. But I said, no, I'm preserving the environment and making it very nice. Not only that, but I'm going also to bring it gardening, which we did, and have sculpture garden and so on. So it was better than it was before there was Makama, and drug addicts was all there on that top of the hill. So the hill remained. In terms of perception, the hill is there. But the car park is below the hill. Nobody knows about that. Anyway, so that's what it is. At that time, it was the biggest building. So it was an international competition. One of the judges is Kendo Tange from Japan. So I was surprised, because when I got that job, I said, my God, this is first one that got very, very big job. So one of the Kendo Tange, of course, the Bank Negara governor, and PEM president, at that time, what's his name? I think it's Epstein, I think, because he's also competing. And another one is the mayor in that time. So
would you recall how many entries in Malaysia, roughly? Malaysian?
Malaysia, almost all of those people there. Yes. More than 50. What big?
International, roughly?
International, about 50. I know, two from Australia. About 50. So it's a big building at that time, 55 stories.
They made a panelist for that after that stage.
Yes.
How many firms that managed?
No, they don't need to just go competition on that, they just choose one.
Oh, that's it.
That's it. That's good. But it takes a long time for them to, in a way, appoint me. Because they say, you are young, you haven't got experience and so on. So we got to get somebody with experience from Australia to keep an eye on us. And also to do whatever it is to go through, just to convince the people at that time or the bank that I have that. Of course, we have to do research. I got to go around the world with the bankers as well. We went to California, and I mean, we had great times, of course. And even I went to UBS, Union Bank of Switzerland, who was treated very royally by the bankers over there. To see all their building, how they manage it, and even that time there was security systems coming in during that time in the bank. And I went to see the gold ingots, you know, how it's stored and so on. So that was an education in a way, you know, not to expand that. So, having got that, of course, that is the first time also this computer drafting coming to be. That was very elementary time at the time. We used very big paint and for plotting. And the plotting was not steady because humidity and so on. And I bought a very expensive system called computer vision. And they tried to tell me computer vision is used by Boeing. So I was, if it's good for America, it must be good for us. So
was it a joint firm appointment?